his artistry, his design, his sensitivity.
He looked on stones as talking to him.
Zaavy understood all that romanticism.
Hell-bent on creating the world's most remarkable pieces of jewellery.
Il était un peu l'électron, un peu comme ça, révolutionnaire de la famille. Celle de Frédéric était spéciale pour les pierres, déjà tout petit. Mais je sais que les petits garçons aiment toujours la pierre comme de quelque chose qui vient de la terre. Frédéric a eu un itinéraire très particulier. Très jeune, il a quitté la maison. Il est parti à l'étranger, dans une espèce de bohème, de vie très proche de la terre, très proche de la nature. Mon père, étant désespéré de cette situation, lui demande absolument de faire quelque chose de plus sérieux dans sa vie. Et ils décident ensemble que mon frère irait faire des études à Los Angeles et donc devenir un expert en gemmologie. L'aventure a commencé par essayer de faire, de se rapprocher le plus possible de la nature sur des projets de broches, de fleurs, en forme de fleurs, de bagues, de colliers, enfin, toute une ligne de bijoux. Sa motivation était de faire des choses magnifiques, merveilleuses, avec son trésor de pierre, et de réaliser une collection de joaillerie magnifique. Je ne sais pas si à ce moment-là, il savait qu'il aurait une vie très courte, mais tout ce qu'il a fait, il l'a fait très intensément, tout le temps.
In 2007, we had the mammoth challenge of relaunching Fabergé. And Fabergé is perhaps the most magical, most powerful, and most noble of all of the jewelry brands. Where do you find a jeweler that has the ability, the skill, and the vision to portray Fabergé in the modern era? It's a gargantuan challenge. We had heard of a jeweler in Paris, mere whispers, rumors, and legends. And that was how we happened upon the amazing works that Frédéric Zaavy had created.
I was really blown away by his artistry, his design, his sensitivity, and his relationship to Fabergé of the past. Peter Carl Fabergé, my great-grandfather, described himself as an artist jeweler, and I think Frédéric Zaavy embodied that. His use of coloured stones is very gentle. He understands the idea to enchant.
Little stones, big stones, the juxtapositions of them. When you mix colour and light, he looked on stones as talking to him. It's a very different interpretation of stones, entirely out of the box, as it were.
Each one of his pieces was a one-off. He believed that art was the driving force behind jewellery. There was absolutely no way that he was going to make two items based on the same design. And so that link between Fabergé and Zaavy was perfectly natural.
Il a été également très motivé par tout ce qui était art russe, déjà, de l'âme profonde de la joaillerie.
I love flowers. Very delicate flowers. In my 8 years, I don't know if they are coming from anywhere. They are there. It is how open you are to this vast, immense space in front of us, full of questions and visions. As far as Fabergé and my work is concerned, yes, I would compare that. There is something happening that makes you somehow feel better and feel lighter.
The Nymphia bracelet comprises 5,200 individually set gemstones.
In there, there are the tiniest of stones, but they all compete to give the overall impression of what he's trying to give. He was an artist, and he painted with jewels.
La couleur des fleurs qui devait forcément lui rappeler la couleur des pierres, puisqu'il a fait de magnifiques bracelets jonquilles. Son magnifique bracelet nymphéas, qui s'est retrouvé dans la collection Fabergé, a été bien sûr d'inspiration de Monet.
It's a shame that he was taken from us so young.
He was so driven by his vision of creating the world's greatest jewelry.
He started being a jeweler when he was 30 years of age. When Frédéric died, he was only 46. He was in his prime. He had already produced masterpieces.
During the course of our four-year collaboration with Frédéric before his untimely death in 2011, we had completed with him 141 absolutely unique, one-of-a-kind pieces.
Frédéric Zaavy has left the Fabergé of today with a wonderful legacy. They are like a piece of art.
Tout était passionné, très intense, et vécu chaque seconde et chaque chose et chaque pierre et chaque était un événement et gai et glorieux, et il était captivé par la beauté de ces pierres.
He was an artist and he painted with jewels.